Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to learn eigenvalue buckling analysis using ANSYS Workbench. So buckling is one of the major cause of failure in structures, machine elements or support power bridges, and therefore the possibility of buckling should always be considered in design. So learning in the video is introduction to eigenvalue buckling analysis, Euler's formula that is the base of eigenvalue buckling analysis, and the main type of support conditions in a column, then buckling examples that we are going to solve by Euler's workbench as well as by Euler's formula, and result validation. So whatever results we obtain using ANSYS workbench and Euler's formula, we are going to compare that results. So keep watching this video till the end. So eigenvalue buckling analysis is predict the theoretical buckling strength of an ideal elastic structure. So if you have a column and it is experienced by a axial compressive force, then it is going to buckle in lateral direction, right? So it is the strength of that member which resists this lateral deformation, and if this stress is greater than your limiting stress, then your structure is going to fail. That is, it is for only elastic structure. That means your material should be obey the Hooke's law. So this method corresponding to the textbook approach to an elastic buckling analysis. So this elastic buckling analysis is very important here. So it is only for elastic nature of the material. Then for instance, eigenvalue buckling analysis of column matches the classical Euler's solutions. So whatever software you are going to use, it is totally based on these classical Euler solutions. So in mechanical, an eigenvalue buckling analysis is linear analysis and therefore cannot account for non-linearities. So the analysis we are going to learn in this ANSYS workbench, it is totally linear analysis. It cannot consider that non-linearity, which can be in geometry or materials or in contact, right? So here the procedure requires a preloaded environment from which we draw solution data for using the eigenvalue buckling analysis. So here we required preloaded environment. That means we have to perform one of the analysis before the eigenvalue analysis, and whatever the results we have obtained from that analysis or environment, it is used as a base data or base solution for eigenvalue analysis. Then based on this requirement, eigenvalue buckling analysis can consider non-linearities that are present in the pre-stress environment, allowing you to obtain more accurate real-world solution as compared to a traditional linear preloaded state. So some of the example may not consider the real-world solutions or data because the non-linearity available with the example. But in this case, we have to perform this base analysis, we can say, or the initial pre-stress environment we have to consider before this eigenvalue buckling analysis. Therefore, we are going to consider the non-linearity. That means your analysis can be linear or non-linear. That is pre-stress environment. Then it is linked to your eigenvalue buckling analysis. Then we are going to consider the more real world solutions or situation in this type of analysis. So point to remember here, eigenvalue buckling analysis must be linked to a static structural analysis. So this static structural analysis, either linear, non-linear, and the linear perturbation procedure refers to as a base analysis. So we cannot perform directly eigenvalue buckling analysis, we have to link it to a static structural analysis. That means your static structural analysis can be linear or non-linear. So whatever non-linearity we are going to consider in your base analysis, it is going to link to the eigenvalue buckling analysis. So you can model more real world example in this case. This is a main criteria to conduct any buckling eigenvalue buckling analysis. Here we have to perform static structure analysis first, then it is going to link to your eigenvalue buckling analysis. So linear based eigenvalue buckling analysis. So in this video, we are going to focus on linear buckling analysis instead of non-linearity. So following are the points we have to consider for this linear type of analysis. So whatever loading conditions we have to define this condition in the upstream analysis, that is static upstream analysis. So we are not going to define any load conditions in the eigenvalue buckling analysis. So whatever conditions we have to assign it in the first simulation, first analysis, that is static buckling analysis. Then here, this eigenvalue buckling analysis will find buckling load four factors. So that is load as that is known as load multiplier or buckling load factor. So it scales all the loads applied in the static structural analysis. So it will scale the loads that we have applied in a static structural analysis. So for example, if you apply 10 Newton compressive load on structure in static analysis, and if the magnitude of the eigenvalue buckling analysis calculate a load factor of 150, then predicted buckling load is 150 into 10 equal to 1500 Newton. So here we apply 10 Newton force, compressive force a load, and if this the buckling load factors, which is calculated by eigenvalue buckling analysis, is 150, then your buckling load or critical load is equal to 1500 Newton. That means it multiply or scale the your applied load. Therefore, the 1500 Newton is your critical load, right? The buckling load, we can say. So because of this, it is typical to apply unit loads in the static analysis that predict the buckling analysis. So I always recommend you to apply unit load in static analysis instead of a given loads. Or sometimes it is our unknown. Therefore, apply unit load. So whatever the value of buckling load occurs that has calculated using eigenvalue buckling is your buckling load value, right? That means when you apply load, unit load factor, unit loads is equal to your buckling load factor, which is equal to your critical loads. So this is a trick to find out the buckling load in eigenvalue analysis. So buckling load factor is to be applied to all the loads used in the static analysis. So whatever number of loads you have applied, it is multiplied by this buckling load factor. So Euler's formula. So here PCR, that is critical load, equal to pi square pi upon h square. So here PCR, that is critical load in Newton, I is a moment of inertia of the principal axis about which buckling occurs, that is in mm^2. Then E is Young's modulus of material in megapascal, and L is effective length of column in mm. This is a classical Euler formula for buckling analysis. Then there are most four mostly common support conditions are listed below. Here the first condition is pin-pin column support conditions. In this case, one of the end is fixed, other end is pin. In this case, the effective length will be equal to your original length of the column. Therefore, this is the formula for final formula for critical load. And K is here effective length factor. So here first is critical load, second L is your effective length, and third K is your effective length factor. So these are the four common support conditions used for the any column. Second is fixed free column. In this case, one of the end is fixed to the ground and another end is open. In this case, effective length equal to 2L, and K is that means K is your factor, effective length factor is 2, and this is your final critical load equation. Then third condition is fixed fixed column. So both end of the column is fixed, and in this case effective length equal to 0.5L. So K is your 0.5U, and this is the final equation for the critical load. Then last condition is fixed pin column. So one of the end of the column is fixed and other end is pin. In this case L is effective length equal to 0.699L. K is your 0.669. This is the four most commonly used support conditions for the columns, and it is very important to know the this effective length. So because we all know that the length in this Euler formula is your effective length, therefore we should know this effective length for all the support conditions. So here we are going to solve this example is a cross section, that is rectangular one, and B is a breadth, and D is a depth of this rectangular column. And dimension of the column is, length is 2.2 meter, and breadth is 210 mm, and depth is 280 mm, and it is under axial compressive load, that is P, and the material of this column is aluminum, and in smallness is equal to 70 gigapascal. So here we have to find the critical load to buckle the column. So here we have to find this critical load, right, P. Then if allowable compressive stress in the aluminum is 240 MPa, then we have to find the column is going to buckle or not, or yield. So we have to find this critical stress, compressive stress, by this limiting stress. Then if the factor of safety is 1.95, then what is allowable buckling load? So all these three outputs we have to find based on this given inputs, dimensions and material property. So let's open our Ansible bench. So here the graphic user interface of this Ansible bench, and this is your schematic window. Let's create a static XML analysis team for this drag and drop. This is team in Puyo schematic. So here our static structure analysis is ready. First we have to create aluminum material in engineering data. For this click on engineering data. So here we don't have available aluminum material in the library, so we have to create it in this outline of schematic. In the engineering data, click on this cell and give the name aluminum. Here we have to insert some properties like isotropic elasticity. We will click on this isotropic elasticity and give the value in megapascal, that is 70,000. Right? Then Poisson's ratio we are going to consider is 0.3. Next, the property we are going to insert is compressive yield strength, that is 240, right? So click on this property and give the value in MPa, that is 240. So in this way we have created material that we require for the simulation. So click on the project, and next we have to create geometry using the design modeler. So here our design modeler window is ready. Select ZX plane, look at, click on sketching mode, then select rectangle tool from the draw toolbox, create rectangle here, two dimensions instead of symmetry. So in this way we have created the rectangle with the given dimensions. You click on the ISO board and select modeling mode, then use the extrude feature. We have to extrude this rectangle, then select any edge of this rectangle, apply, and the depth is 2200 mm, right? And then click on generate. So here we have created our column with a given configuration. Then close this design modeler. Then double click on this model to open mechanical workbench. On mechanical window, right? So here our mechanical window is ready. You can see the outlines, the outline here. We have to change the material for the given geometry, that is your column. For this, the default material is structural steel. You can see in the assignment, we have to change it to the aluminum, right? So we have changed the material here. Then generate default mesh. So very good mesh is created, because is the regular geometry. All the hex element is created. Then click on the static structural, and we have to do the loads. Before that, supports. It is fixed support in the bottom face. Select the bottom face of this column, apply, and again click on these loads and select force. Then select the top face of this column, apply, here define the loads by component instead of vector. I recommend you to always use this component instead of vector, right, to define the loads. So we have to do the load in a negative y direction, that is here minus 1 newton. So we have discussed why we are going to unit load for this eigenvalue buckling analysis, because the eigenvalue buckling analysis will find your this load multiplier, a buckling load factor, which is equal to your critical loads. Therefore we have to apply this unit loads here. Then here the boundary conditions, load conditions are given here. Then we don't want any solutions in this base analysis, but you can also insert different type of outputs like deformation stresses, but we don't require here. So this is the first base analysis we have ready. We have to solve it. So here our solution is ready. That means solution data is ready. We have to link this solution with your eigenvalue buckling analysis. For this, we have to close this mechanical unit. Right, then we have to couple this static analysis with your eigenvalue buckling analysis. So there is a two way you can drag and drop this eigenvalue buckling analysis system onto the solution cell of this static structure analysis, or right click on the solution cell, then transfer data to new eigenvalue buckling. So it will transfer all data of this static structure analysis to with your eigenvalue buckling analysis. Here double click on this setup cell. To open the eigenvalue buckling analysis. So here you will find the static structural we have done before, which is linked to the eigenvalue buckling analysis. That is pre-stress environment, we can say. Here you also see the pre-stress environment, that is your static structural analysis, right? So here in the eigenvalue buckling load, there is a analysis settings. Click on this and details of the analysis setting, you will find maximum modes to find. That is, it is, you can change it to 2, 3, 4, 5. But here the least mode shape or the deformation or the load factor is interest of our. Because whatever the values we are getting after this first mode, it is not of that interest. Therefore you can keep it 2 or 3. So I am going to keep it 2, because the first mode shape is of important, right? Then here we have to solve the solutions. Right click on solution and solve. So here you can see our solution is ready. And you can see at the bottom of this mechanical window, here is a load multiplier, that is your buckling load factor. The first is of our interest, that is 7.7392 e raised to 6, that is, which is equal to 7739 kilo newton. That is our, this load multiplier is equal to our critical load, because we have applied the force is equal to 1 unit force. So whatever the buckling load factor we get, it is our critical load. So as we discussed in the presentation. So here this is our critical load we have found using the ISIS eigenvalue buckling analysis or ISIS workbench. So we have to validate these answers that we have obtained in ISIS workbench with our classical Euler method. So for this the same example we have solved in the workbench. Here it is solved in the internet, so I find it in the internet, and you can find the same load conditions and boundary conditions here. So for this website has used your formula to find the critical load here. In our case is fixed free end. That means one of the end of the column is fixed, another end is free. In this case, the equivalent length is equal to 2L, that is equal to 4.4 meter, and inertia, that is calculated by using the formula BD cube by 12. So here we have two inertias, that means along x axis and along y axis. So the least inertia are going to use in this formula. So by using this formula, by keeping the putting all the values in this formula, we get the values here 77.11 kN. But in you can see a very approximate value we are going by using this ANSI coil bearing, that is 77.39. So it is very close to your analytical method, right? So next, our column is going to buckle or yield. So for this, we have to divide this critical load using this area. It will give you stress, that is critical stress, which is equal to critical force upon area. So area is equal to your V2D, that is 210 into 280. So your critical stress equal to 113.1 MPa. So if critical stress is less than 240 MPa, the column will buckle. If the stress greater than 240 MPa, the column will yield. So your value is 131.1 is less than your 240, that is compressive stress. Therefore, the column is going to buckle instead of yield, right? And the third one, that is your allowable load. In this case, we have factor of safety is 1.95. So to find out the allowable load, we have formula that critical load upon factor of safety. So 77.11 kN divided by 1.95, which is equal to 3954 kN. So this is a these values of critical load, then critical stresses and allowable load is calculated in this example by using this Euler formula. The same way we have find out the critical load here, that is 7739 kN. So here we have make one comparison, that is result analysis, we can say a result validation. So parameter here, critical load, critical buckling stress and allowable buckling stress. For this we have area B2D equal to 210 into 280 is equal to 58800 m², and factor of safety is equal to 1.95. So this is how we have solved the classical Euler's method, and this is the values we have seen in your this buckling example that is solved in the internet. Then same values, this value we have obtained in ANSI workbench, that is 7740 kN. So by dividing this value with your area, that is equal to 58800, you will get the same critical buckling stress, which is obtained by using the classical Euler's formula. Then again, 7740 divided by 1.95, that is factor of safety, it will give you the allowable buckling load by using the ANSI workbench. So this is a value which is very near to your classical Euler's formula. So this is a numerical method, we know that the values we have obtained by using this softwares or numerical methods is very not accurate or 100% accurate, but it is approximate to your classical methods. Therefore, you can see that your results is very matching with your these classical methods. So this is a simple technique we can so experience, gain some confidence for our results, then we can proceed for the more complex examples. So friends, if you like my video, please subscribe and share with your friends, and thank you.